This is step four of the Dubsado blueprint. I'm calling this step Pour the Foundation. In this step, we're going to start filling out your form template section. So let me show you how to do that. We're going to start out by going to the left pane and selecting templates from there. And then we're going to go to the Forms tab. Now, if you look here, you can see that there are five different types of forms. There are contracts, subagreements, questionnaires, proposals, and lead captures. And then if you look over here in the upper right corner, you can get some inspiration by looking at what's called the template library. So you can look in the template library for some ideas on what you might want yours to look like. Now, the order that I just listed these forms in is the order that you should create your forms in Dubsado. So you're going to start out by creating a contract and then subagreements if you have any, then questionnaires, and then proposals. You'll actually save lead captures for a later time, so don't worry about those now. Now, you might be wondering, what do I do if I send a welcome kit or an info packet? You can actually send those under questionnaires. So questionnaires are kind of a tricky name because you don't necessarily have to send any questions in questionnaires. You just have the ability to. So questionnaires are good for any documents that you want to send alone that are not contracts, subagreements, or proposals. Now, proposals are multi-page documents that you're bundling together. So if you want to send a document by itself, you would send that under a questionnaire. If you wanted to send that document along with a contract and an invoice, you would upload that into proposals. You also have the ability to upload full page JPEGs. So if you want to send a welcome kit that you've created in Canva that's beautifully branded or in Adobe InDesign, you can upload those here and send it to them. So you don't necessarily have to use all the form elements in Dubsado to build them out. So you'll start creating them by clicking the plus sign, and then you can just click on these elements on the side and start adding them. So if you wanted to upload a full page PDF or a smaller image, you would just select image and then upload from there. And this pane will open up. You'll upload the image from your computer and proceed. You can customize the text of your forms by clicking on the text box and then highlighting and changing the fonts up above and the font size, etc. So that's how you set up your forms, and you're good to go. If you found this video helpful, make sure you give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments below, and I'll try to help you out as best I can. I'll see you in the next video.